It was deadline day in the horse slaughter lawsuit. The attorney general's office had to pay a large bond to keep that case going, but it didn't do it. Action 7 News reporter Regina Reese joins us to explain why.
Well, the bond of more than $400,000 had to be paid by 5 p.m. today. But instead of handing over the money, the attorney general's office filed a motion to get out of paying it altogether.
The fight to ban horse slaughter continues.
The polling that's been done shows that a very high percentage of New Mexicans and a very high percentage of Americans that are subject to pretty reliable scientific polling are opposed to this.
A judge recently granted a temporary injunction to keep horse slaughterhouses from opening. The attorney general's office says it has a strong case, but it is not willing to pay the $435,000 bond a judge ordered. The money would have covered the losses for Valley Meat Company in Roswell while the case is decided.
It is generally not necessary to have a high bond in that because you weigh the private interest, the private economic interest, against the broader public interest of having the environment protected.
The Attorney General's office's motion is requesting no bond. Now representatives from Valley Meat Company will respond, and a judge will make the final ruling.
Certainly the public deserves a decision quickly, and quite honestly, so do the private parties.
A local decision that could have a nationwide effect on the future of horse slaughter in our country.
This week, a proposed slaughterhouse in Iowa dropped its plans to open because of the financial impact during litigation. It will now focus on cattle, but Valley Meat says it will see the deal through.
In the next month, a hearing will decide the future of the temporary injunction.